You're starting to add threat intelligence to your MISP instance. Then disaster. You soon find out it is very hard to keep up with the constant flow of new threats and intelligence. Let me show you how to use threat intelligence feeds with MISP to save countless hours of work. MISP is a de facto open source threat intelligence platform used worldwide to share, collate, analyze, and distribute threat intelligence. The most efficient way to use the platform is to integrate threat intelligence feeds, which automatically add intelligence without you lifting a finger. Cyber threat intelligence feeds are sources of timely and relevant information about cybersecurity threats and vulnerabilities. They often contain a list of indicators of compromise that a company can use to generate detections or alerts using their security solutions. There are two main types of CTI feeds. Free and open source CTI feeds that are curated by the community for the benefit of the community. Examples of these include Alien Vault OTX, FBI InfraGuard Portal, and ThreatFox by Abuse.ch. There's also closed and proprietary feeds that are curated by the commercial cyber threat intelligence providers. These you have to pay to get access for and include Intel 471's Titan platform, Recorded Future, and CrowdStrike Falcon Intelligence. MISP comes installed with a range of free and open source CTI feeds, although you can choose to add your own closed and proprietary feeds if you want. Although IOCs are not the best way to track new and emerging threats, they still play an important role in defending an organization from known bad, and their ingestion and detection can be automated. So, how do you use them in MISP? MISP feeds are remote or local resources containing indicators that can be automatically imported into MISP at regular intervals. These CTI feeds can expose their data to MISP in CSV or free text formats and can be imported by querying a remote or local URL. They can also be protected by authentication or freely accessible on the web. Feeds offer a simple way to gather intelligence from various external sources without needing programming or scripting skills. Additionally, you don't need to set up or configure your own CTI feeds to begin working with them in MISP. MISP comes installed with several default feeds that you can use immediately. All you have to do is enable them. To use feeds in MISP, you must be logged in as the administrator user. Once logged in, you'll see Feeds under the Sync Actions menu. Clicking Feeds will bring you to the Feed screen. Here, you'll see all the default feeds listed. Click the Load Default Feed Meta button to load all the default feeds. This will populate the Feed screen with all the default threat intelligence feeds that come with your MISP instance. To use a feed, you need to enable it and enable caching. Caching for a feed will download all the feed's IOCs as attributes onto your MISP instance's Redis server. You can then search through these attributes and see correlations between data published in your MISP instance and stored in your cache. To do this, select the feeds you want to use and click the Enable Selected and Enable Caching for Selected buttons. You can cache all the feeds that use the free text slash CSV format, or all feeds that use the MISP events format to your Redis server using the options at the top of the feed screen. This will give you a lot of threat intelligence to search through. Once you have enabled a feed, you can view it by clicking the Enabled Feeds view. To use the feed, select one of the caching or actions buttons. Going from left to right, we have Cache Feed, which lets you cache feed data in your MISP's Redis database to correlate it with MISP attributes that are stored on your instance. Next, we have Explore the Events Remotely. This lets you search through a feed's data to find IOCs, which is useful for investigations and threat hunting. Next, we have Fetch All Events. This lets you ingest the data into your MISP instance as events. After this, we have the Edit button. This lets you edit configuration details about a feed, such as the metadata, authentication parameters, how the data is distributed, and any default tags or filtering rules you want to add. Then we have the Delete button. This lets you remove a feed from your MISP instance. And finally, we have download feed metadata as JSON. This lets you download a feed's metadata, including its name, URL, further rules, configuration details, and more. If you have your own CTI feed you want to ingest data from, you can add a new feed into MISP. To do this, click the Add Feed button on the left side menu. This will bring up the Add MISP Feed Dynamic web form, where you can fill in data about the new feed you want to add to your MISP instance. At a minimum, you should enable and cache the feed, provide a name and provider, define the input source, local or remote, give a URL to pull the data from, define the format this data will be in. This can be MISP, free text or CSV. Set the distribution rules for events that are automatically created using this feed, and add a default tag. You may need to add other information such as filter rules if you want to exclude certain data, or how to parse the free text / CSV format. Click submit once you are done. This will bring you back to the feed screen, where you can find the newly created feed by clicking the Enabled Feeds button. Now you know how to work with MISP feeds, let's take a look at some of the common pitfalls you should avoid and useful tips that will allow you to make the most of MISP feeds. So far, to fetch or cache feed data, you've been doing this manually by going to Feeds in the Sync Actions menu. This is a tedious, repetitive task that can be alleviated with the power of automation. To do this in MISP, you can create a scheduled task. You can create a scheduled task in MISP to automatically fetch and or cache feeds by going to the Administration menu and selecting the Scheduled Tasks option. You'll be presented with the Scheduled Task screen. Here you can edit the default scheduled tasks your MISP instance has created automatically on first install. To edit a scheduled task, you can click either the Frequency, Scheduled Time, or Next Run options. This task will run once every day at 12 o'clock. When you're done, click Update All to finalize your choice. You can also use cron jobs to automate tasks on your MISP instance. These provide further customization options and granularity, as you can either run simple bash scripts yourself or use one that comes pre-installed with MISP. See the automating certain console tasks in the MISP documentation for a list of scripts you can schedule to run. MISP lets you work with feed data in two ways. First, you can ingest the data into your MISP instance and automatically create MISP events from the CTI feed. Second, you can cache the feed data in your MISP instance Redis database to search through and correlate with your MISP attributes. There are pros and cons of both these methods. For instance, creating events from feed data lets you easily share and export the IOCs. However, it will fill your MISP instance with data that might not be relevant to your organization. On the other hand, choosing to cache feed data allows you to search open source CTI feeds and correlate attributes or IOCs in your MISP instance with these external data sources. I personally chose the latter option. I manually review everything I put in my MISP instance to ensure it is legitimate intelligence and is relevant to the organization I am protecting. I then use external CTI feeds to correlate this data and also to search for IOCs when threat hunting. Indicators have a limited shelf life. Adversaries change hash values, URLs, domains, IP addresses, and then move on. You can reflect this change by adding an IOC lifetime in your MISP instance using decaying models that assign a score to each MISP attribute. This score decreases over time to reflect the importance of an IOC, and it lets you expire old IOCs and place less importance on them as they age. You can then remove them from your MISP instance to avoid wasting time for old or expired data. To use decaying models in MISP, go to the Global Actions menu and select List Decaying Models option. This will bring up the Decaying Models screen. Click the Update Default Models option from the left side menu to load the default decay models that come with your MISP instance. This will populate the decay model screen with a list of default models that come with your MISP install. You can use the buttons under the Actions column to view, download, edit, and enable the models. You can add your own decay models or import one using the options on the left side menu. However, for now, we will just apply a default one to our MISP attributes. To do this, select the Decay Models tool option in the left side menu. This will bring you to the Decaying of Indicator Fine Tuning tool screen. Here, you can tune how MISP attributes decay over time by giving them a lifetime, decay speed, cutoff threshold, and base score that gets added to them once ingested into your MISP instance. These will start an attribute at a score and gradually decrease this score to zero, at which point the attribute can be considered expired. You can choose to select multiple attributes, assign these factors to them, and then create your own decay model using the Create button. However, using one of the default decay models MISP provides is a lot easier. To do this, scroll down to the model you want to use and select Load Model. This will load the model into the fine-tuning tool where you can see which attributes it affects and how it affects them. Here I have selected the NIDS Simple Decay model which affects network indicators. If you are happy with the model, select the Enable button to start using it. Once enabled, you will now see a score field next to the MISP attributes that relate to the decay model you enabled. This reflects the current value an attribute has, and it will decrease over time. Navigate to an event and click the Decay Score to see this. Decay models are a great way to manage the data in your MISP instance and apply a measure of importance to your IOCs. I recommend exploring feeds in your own MISP instance. Start by using one of MISP's default CTI feeds, then move on to creating your own threat intelligence feed, either locally or by pulling from a well-known open source feed. You can then test if ingesting or caching feed data works best for you and how to automate this with a scheduled task. The next installment in this series will look at efficiently searching and filtering MISP events and attributes to look for information in your MISP instance. This will empower you to use MISP as an investigation tool during your incident response, threat hunting, or security research.